All right. So in our third module of business law, that is under special contract, we have started learning regarding agency. Then we understood the meaning of agent, and then we understood the types of agents. These are the types of agents: general agent, special agent, sub agent, substituted agent, co-agent, and then mercantile agent. These are the types of agents. And why there is a need to understand these types of agents? Because each and every type of agent is having their own responsibilities. They are having their own role to play for the principal. Because agent is a person who has been appointed or employed by the principal. And principal is giving his authority to the agent to represent him in front of third party. So whatever activities the agent is doing, he is doing on behalf of his principal. And whatever decision he is making, that is also on behalf of the principal. So if any decision goes wrong or if any loss is happening, then who should bear that loss based on the ground? So for that, there is need to understand these types of agents, because each and every type of agent is having their own amount of responsibility, their own amount of risk. And there are so many situations where even principal is also getting relieved from the responsibility. For example, when we were discussing regarding sub agent, we understood that there are two situations: that when the principal is aware about the appointment of sub agent, and the second situation was when he was not aware about the appointment of sub agent. So like that, there are so many things which are in the form of provision under these types of agent. So up to this, we have understood in our previous lecture. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to understand what are the duties of the parties to the agency. Now, so far, we are very much clear that what is an agency? What is an agency? Agency means the relationship between principal and agent. एजेंट और प्रिंसिपल के बीच का जो लीगल रिलेशनशिप है उसे कहा जाता है एजेंसी, राइट? तो इस एजेंसी में कितने पार्टीज होती हैं? देर आर टू पार्टीज, वन इज प्रिंसिपल एंड वन इज एजेंट, एंड बोथ द पार्टीज आर हैविंग देयर ड्यूटीज टू वन अनदर. लाइक एजेंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू द प्रिंसिपल एंड प्रिंसिपल इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू एजेंट. बोथ ऑफ देम आर हैविंग द ड्यूटीज टू वन अनदर एज वेल एज दे आर हैविंग राइट्स ओवर ईच अदर. एजेंट इज हैविंग सर्टेन राइट्स ओवर प्रिंसिपल एंड प्रिंसिपल्स आर हैविंग सम राइट्स ओवर एजेंट, राइट? सो बोथ आर हैविंग देयर ओन राइट्स, बोथ आर हैविंग देयर ओन ड्यूटीज. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड वन बाय वन दैट व्हाट आर द वेरियस ड्यूटीज एंड राइट्स व्हिच आर एंजॉयड बाय द पार्टीज. नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल अंडरस्टैंड रिगार्डिंग द ड्यूटीज ऑफ एन एजेंट. एक एजेंट के ड्यूटीज क्या क्या होती हैं? द फर्स्ट ड्यूटी व्हिच इज डिस्क्राइब्ड इन द एक्ट, इट इज फॉलोइंग द इंस्ट्रक्शंस. सी, प्रिंसिपल इज अपॉइंटिंग एन एजेंट टू हेल्प हिम, क्योंकि प्रिंसिपल हर जगह पे नहीं पहुंच सकता है, हर जगह पे अपना काम खत्म नहीं कर सकता है, तो इसलिए उसने एजेंट को अपॉइंट किया. नाउ प्रिंसिपल वांट्स दैट द वर्क शुड गेट डन द वे इन विच ही वॉन्ट्स टू. सो प्रिंसिपल इज गिविंग इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू द एजेंट दैट सी दिस इज हाउ यू हैव टू डू द वर्क. सो ही इज गिविंग द इंस्ट्रक्शंस दैट हाउ द वर्क शुड बी गेटिंग डन, एंड इट इज द जॉब ऑफ द एजेंट टू फॉलो दीज इंस्ट्रक्शंस वेरी क्लियरली. ही हैज टू फॉलो द इंस्ट्रक्शंस व्हिच आर गिवन बाय प्रिंसिपल एंड ही शुड नॉट वायोलेट एनी काइंड ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन. दैट इज हिज ड्यूटी. अगर एक पर्टिकुलर इंस्ट्रक्शन दिया गया है तो एजेंट को वही फॉलो करना है, वो उसको वायोलेट नहीं कर सकता. और अगर उसने वो चीजें वायोलेट कर दी या उसके खिलाफ गया जो इंस्ट्रक्शन उसे दी गई थी, तो जिस चीज के अगेंस्ट में गया है या जो इंस्ट्रक्शन उसने फॉलो नहीं किया है, प्रिंसिपल कैन चार्ज यू नो मनी फॉर दैट, प्रिंसिपल कैन चार्ज डैमेजेस फॉर दैट. अगर मैंने एक एजेंट को अपॉइंट किया था कि मेरे बिहाफ में कुछ शेयर्स खरीद लो, ब्रोकर को अपॉइंट किया लेट अस से, और मैंने उसे इंस्ट्रक्शंस दिए थे कि ये कंपनीज में ही तुम शेयर्स को इन्वेस्ट करना है, बाकी कंपनीज के बारे में नहीं करना है, ये मैंने बोल दिया. लेकिन उस बंदे ने क्या किया, ऐसी कंपनीज में शेयर्स इन्वेस्ट किए जो इंस्ट्रक्शंस मैंने नहीं दिए थे, और अगर उसमें मुझे लॉस हो गया देन आई कैन क्लेम दैट डैमेजेस और लॉस फ्रॉम द एजेंट. व्हाई आई कैन क्लेम द डैमेजेस और लॉसेस फ्रॉम एजेंट, बिकॉज क्लियरली आई हैव गिवन सर्टेन इंस्ट्रक्शंस एंड इट इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ एन एजेंट टू फॉलो दीज इंस्ट्रक्शंस. दैट इज अ वेरी फर्स्ट ड्यूटी ऑफ द एजेंट. Then the second duty of agent is conducting business with his skill and diligence. Skill means the quality which he's having. Of course, he's expert in some field. That is the reason he has become the agent, to help others. Whereas diligence means careful. He has to work very carefully. उसको ऐसा नहीं लगना चाहिए कि अरे मेरा पैसा थोड़ी ना है, प्रिंसिपल का पैसा है, डूबने दो तो डूबने दो. ऐसा attitude बिल्कुल नहीं होना चाहिए. He has to be very diligent, he has to be very careful, and he has to use his skills, whatever he is having. Because he is having that skill, because he is having that quality, that is why he is an agent, that is why he is earning on that skill. So he has to follow, he has to see that he is using his skill, and carefully he is making decision. Because you are taking decision, wo kisi aur ke liye le rahe ho. जब किसी और के लिए आप डिसीजन ले रहे हो तो आपको और ज्यादा केयरफुल रहना है. सो इट इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ द एजेंट टू बी केयरफुल. लेट अस से ही हैज टेकन एनी डिसीजन और एनी वर्क ही हैज डन और बिजनेस ही हैज डन विथ नॉट सो यू नो केयरफुल माइंड और केयरलेसली ही हैज टेकन द डिसीजन. ऑफकोर्स वेन यू आर मेकिंग एनी डिसीजन केयरलेसली इट इज गोइंग टू मेक यू सफर फ्रॉम लॉसेस 100%. सो वॉट एवर लॉसेस वन प्रिंसिपल विल गो थ्रू because of the carelessness of the agent, he is having right to recover that. He can go to the court and he can explain to the judge, Sai, I have appointed him as my agent to do this particular work, but carelessly he has taken this decision, and because of that I'm suffering from losses. Please ask him to make the payment of that, and he has to pay that because it is his duty. It is a duty of an agent to conduct the business, that means the work which has been allotted to him, with the skill and diligence. उसको ध्यान से काम करना है. Then the another duty of an agent is rendering accounts to the principal. As far as the meaning of rendering is concerned, rendering means to submit the accounts to the principal. Whatever dealing he is making, it is the duty of the agent to submit the accounts of that very carefully and as per provisions to the principal on timely basis. ऐसा नहीं कि वो अपने पास ही रख देगा. आपने consignment accounting सीखा होगा, right? Consignment accounting में क्या होता है, एक consigner consignee को goods supply करता है और उसके बाद जो भी चीजें होती हैं वो वापस से consigner के पास आ जाती हैं accounts के form में, कि कितना सेल हुआ, कितना प्रॉफिट हुआ, कितना लॉस हुआ. बिकॉज इट इज द राइट ऑफ द पर्सन, the original seller, to know that how much profit he has earned or how much profit or how much loss has been incurred, right? So that is done because accounts are submitted in time. So it is a duty of the agent to render the accounts to the principal on timely basis. That is a duty, rendering accounts to the principal. Then the another duty is communicating with the principal. Communicating means whatever things he is doing, everything should be reported. That is communicating on regular basis, on daily basis. If I have appointed one agent to see some flats as per my choice, so whatever flats he will be seeing, whatever flats he is looking for me, on daily basis he has to approach me, daily basis he has to update me, that see, today I have gone in this area, I have seen two flats and the flat owners are charging this much money, I told them this, the conditions and all. Means whatever he is communicating to the third party on my behalf, he has to communicate that with me, he has to inform each and everything to me. I should know that, what is happening outside, because I have appointed a person as my agent and he is representing myself in front of third party. So it is my right as a principal to know that what is happening. So it is a duty of an agent to communicate with the principal. Then the another duty is not doing business from own account without permission. Let us say one deal is happening, and at that time, principal is not at the place or principal is not approachable. and some deal is to be finalized. So one agent cannot do that deal or that business from his own account. वो अपने account से वो चीजें नहीं कर सकता. It may be anything. It may be bank account or it may be any account. But he cannot do it from his own account unless it is not permitted. If principal is permitting him, okay, now you do the business from your own account on my behalf, that is okay. If he is having permission to do so, he can do that. But if permission is not granted to the agent to do the business from his own account, then he should not do that because law is not permitting it. See, if the deal is happening from one particular account, the profits also will come in that account only. Na? That means the agent may earn the undue profit, or he may, you know, in future, he may blackmail or even, you know, force the principal to enter into some agreement, which principal may not be willing to enter into that. So to prohibit this particular practice, the act has added one thing, that agents are not allowed to do any business from their own account on behalf of principal until and unless it is not permitted. If permission is granted, then they can do the business. Otherwise, they cannot do that. Now, here, the another party is principal. Now, what duties principals are having? The first duty is duty to indemnify. As far as the term indemnify is concerned, indemnify means to make the losses good. And once again, I repeat, to make the losses good. That is a phrase, actually, making the losses good. Now, the meaning of that phrase is that if any loss is happening, then somebody have to take the responsibility that he will be filling that loss. That is the meaning of indemnity or indemnify. So let us say the agent has been appointed by principal to do the activities of the principal, and agent has done the duty, you know, as per the act, as per his knowledge, and without violating the duties, he has done it. But unfortunately, the loss has happened. Now, this loss, whatever has happened, that is not because of the carelessness or because of the, you know, the non-following the instructions of the agent. That has happened. By nature, it had happened. Now, it is the job or the duty of the principal to bear that loss. That is called as duty to indemnify. If any agent have done anything wrong, not knowingly or not intentionally, but that had happened, then it is a duty of the principal to bear that loss. That is the meaning of indemnity or indemnify. That means making the loss good. Kisi ko nuksan hota hai, to jab usse bhar ke diya jata hai, that is called as indemnify. Making the loss good. Making the loss good. That is duty to indemnify. Then the another duty of principal is not to make agent liable for criminal acts. One agent should not give the job of any kind of criminal activity to the agent. And the agent should not be liable also for that. First of all, that should not happen. That should not be there only. But let us say, if any principal is doing any kind of work which is unofficial, then agent cannot be held responsible for that or liable for that particular criminal act. It is a job of the principal to see that the agent is not liable for any criminal act. Because agent is doing work of principal, he is not doing that work willingly. He is doing that work because he is going to get some remuneration out of that. So he should not be held responsible for any criminal act which has been done as per the instructions given by the principal. Principal should not do such things. That is a duty of the principal. Then the next one is duty to compensate. Duty to compensate ka over here meaning comes as if agent have done some expenditures, then it should be compensated to him. Not only the expenditure, if agent is going through some problems or some issues, then even that entire expenditure should be borne by the principal. We take one example. A appointed B as his agent to find the flat in some odd areas. And B, every now and then is going in that area and he's searching the house for the principal. Let us say one fine day, the agent was traveling to that area and unfortunately he met with one accident. Now that accident has happened while doing the work of the principal. Agent apni marzi se to wahan nahi gaya tha. Agent kyun gaya tha? Because principal have asked him to go to that particular place and to search the house, and unfortunately in that area the agent met with an accident. Now he will be hospitalized. So whatever expenditure will be there for his treatment, that should be borne by the principal. That is called as duty to compensate. And this thing is happening or applied everywhere. Even, you know, the workers, those who are working in any company or in any organization, they are general agent. Hum logo ne sikha tha that normal employee of any organization is a general agent. So when we are going to office and if we met with one some accidents and all, then whatever expenditure will come, it should be borne by the employer, the principal. Because we were on the way or we met with the accident because we were working for principal. That is called as duty to compensate. So if anything is happening unpleasant or anything is happening which is not in favor of the agent or agent's health is getting affected, then there's a duty of the principal to compensate all these things. That is the duty of principal. Then the next one is duty to pay agreed commission. Whatever commission they have been agreed upon, it is a duty of the principal to pay. Principal cannot say that, no, I will go back from this word. The deal was not good, so I will not give you that much commission, whatever I promised. No, he cannot do that. अगर मैंने एक ब्रोकर को बोला है कि ये मेरा 1,00,000 रुपया है, ये मार्केट में इन्वेस्ट कर दो और मैं तुम्हें इसके ऊपर 10% कमीशन दे दूंगा, तो 10,000 रुपीज आ जाएगा। लेकिन जब वो 1,00,000 रुपीज इन्वेस्ट हुआ और मुझे सिर्फ 15,000 का ही प्रॉफिट हुआ, पूरा डील करने के बाद 15,000 का प्रॉफिट हुआ, तो जब मैं 10,000 रुपीज एजेंट को पे करूंगा, इन माई माइंड वॉट विल कम, वॉट द थिंग विल कम, दैट पैसा तो मेरा इन्वेस्ट किया हुआ था और मुझे तो सिर्फ 5,000 रुपए मिल रहे हैं और एजेंट को मैं 10,000 रुपए दे रहा हूँ, तो आई कैन टेल हिम दैट नहीं नहीं यार, मेरा पूरा पैसा था, 10,000 रुपए कैसे दे दूँ, सिर्फ मुझे तो 5,000 ही बचेंगे। आई कैन नॉट से लाइक दैट। इफ आई से लाइक दैट, द एजेंट कैन गो टू द कोर्ट एंड देन कोर्ट विल इंस्ट्रक्ट मी टू पे द अमाउंट वॉट एवर आई हैव एग्रीड टू, राइट। अगर लॉस भी हो गया तो भी मुझे वो अमाउंट देना ही पड़ेगा जो मैंने प्रॉमिस किया हुआ है। सो इट इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल टू पे द एग्रीड कमीशन वॉट एवर हैज बीन एग्रीड एट द टाइम ऑफ एग्रीमेंट और एट द सेटअप ऑफ द एजेंसी। ओके, सो दिस इज अनदर पार्ट। ओके, नाउ हियर वी हैव अंडरस्टूड द ड्यूटीज ऑफ बोथ द पार्टीज। नाउ वन थिंग वी शुड कीप इन माइंड, that principal is the opposite of agent and agent is opposite of principal. So duties of an agent will become rights of the principal and duties of principal will become rights of the agent. I hope you understood that, what I'm trying to say, that agent and principal are the two opponents, opposite to one another. So duties of one party will become rights of the another party automatically. For example, over here, it is the duty of the agent to follow the instructions. That is the duty of an agent. So we can say that it is the right of the principal to get the work done from agent as per his instruction. That is the right of the principal. वो principal का अधिकार है कि जैसे instructions दिए जा रहे हैं वैसा ही काम होना चाहिए, because it is a duty of the agent. Then the another one is duty conducting business with a skill and diligence. So it is a right of the principal to see that the work is getting done by using the proper skill and diligence. If the agent is not using his skill or not working diligently, then it is a right of the principal to claim for the damages. Agar uski carelessness ki wajah se, agent ki carelessness ki wajah se, प्रिंसिपल का कुछ नुकसान हो जाता है तो प्रिंसिपल का राइट है वो क्लेम कर, बिकॉज ड्यूटी ऑफ एजेंट इज बिकमिंग राइट ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल. देन रेंडरिंग अकाउंट्स ऑफ द अकाउंट्स टू द प्रिंसिपल, दैट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल. सो इट इज द राइट ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल टू रिसीव द अकाउंट्स इफ एनी एजेंट इज निग्लेक्टिंग ऑफ गिविंग द अकाउंट और मेकिंग डिले इन गिविंग द अकाउंट. देन द प्रिंसिपल इज हैविंग ऑल द राइट्स. ही कैन गो टू द कोर्ट, ही कैन ब्रेक द प्रोमिस इन बिटवीन, ही कैन स्टॉप द पेमेंट ऑफ द एजेंट. वो एजेंट का पेमेंट भी रुका सकता है, वो उसको पूरा राइट मिल जाएगा. वाई? बिकॉज एजेंट हैव वायोलेटेड द ड्यूटी. सो ड्यूटी इज ड्यूटी ऑफ एजेंट इज रेंडरिंग द अकाउंट्स टू द प्रिंसिपल. सो इट इज अ राइट ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल टू रिसीव द अकाउंट्स फ्रॉम द एजेंट. देन कम्युनिकेटिंग विद द प्रिंसिपल, दैट इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ एजेंट. सो वॉट इज द राइट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल? To get communication from agent on regular basis. If agent is not giving the information on regular basis, then principal can make use of the right. वो principal agent को ऐसा भी बोल सकता है कि मैं तुम्हें payment ही नहीं करूंगा क्योंकि तुम मुझे information नहीं दे रहे हैं. और court भी principal को support करेगा. क्यों support करेगा? Because agent is violating with the duties. And when there is violation of duties, it is giving rise to the rights of the principal. प्रिंसिपल को अपने राइट्स को यूज करने का पूरा ये मिल जाता है, चांस मिल जाता है इफ देयर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ वायोलेशन ऑफ द एजेंट ड्यूटी. देन नॉट डूइंग बिजनेस फ्रॉम द अकाउंट, दैट इज द राइट ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल आइदर टू परमिट हिम और नॉट टू परमिट हिम. से अगर मुझे मेरे ब्रोकर के ऊपर पूरा भरोसा है कि वो अच्छा काम ही करता है, ही विल नेवर चीट विथ मी, देन आई कैन गिव द परमिशन, दैट इज माय राइट. लेकिन अगर मुझे लगता है नहीं नहीं दिस एजेंट दिस ब्रोकर इज नॉट सो गुड, ही इज नॉट honest with me, so I will not permit him. So that is my right, either to give the permission or not to give. And it is a duty of the agent to not to use the account unless it is not permitted. Now over here, duties of principal, that is duty to indemnify. Duty to indemnify means if any loss is happening, you know, intentionally, but incidentally some loss has happened from the hands of the agent, then it is the right of agent to collect it from principal. Principal cannot deny for that. It is the right of the agent to collect any kind of loss which has happened during the transaction. We have discussed so many examples, no? When we were discussing regarding the types of agents, you know, that one flat was purchased, of advance was paid, and then towards the end, the principal was going back from the words, then who should bear the loss? So this is the example of duty to indemnify. It is a duty of the principal to pay for the losses if any loss has happened, and it is a right of the agent to get that amount from the principal if any loss has happened. Then to make the agent liable for criminal acts. Let us say the activity which has been allotted to the agent turned out into the criminal activity. Then, of course, you know, police will arrest the agent because he was actually doing that particular work. Then agent will say that, no, I was not doing this work for me. I was doing this work as per instruction by the principal and I was not aware that this is a criminal activity. Please leave me. That is his right to say that. And it is a duty of the principal to relieve him. Principal ko jana hi padega court mein ki nahi iski galati nahi hai. That is a duty of the principal and that is a right of the agent to get it. Right? Then the duty to compensate. As we discussed that if any expenditure is made by the agent, it is a right of the agent to recover that amount from the principal to get the compensation. If any agent is meeting with any accident, then it is a right of the agent to recover that amount of hospital bills and all from the principal. So duty of the principal is becoming right of the agent. And then duty to pay the agreed commission, it is a duty of the principal to pay the agreed amount of commission to the agent. And it is a right of an agent to collect the amount of commission which has been agreed upon from the principal. So here we have discussed two things, duties and rights of agent and principal. So if you are focusing only on duties, automatically you are discussing regarding the rights, because duties of one party is becoming rights of the another party. So with this particular part, the contract of agency, which is considered as the special contract, comes to an end. In this particular chapter, we are having three types of special contracts. Out of these three, one was contract of agency, which we have understood and we have completed today. So in our next period, we will be discussing the another special contract, that is contract of guarantee.